Hi, my name's Ian Van Tuyl, and behind me is a new listing of mine. It is a 2006 Jeanneau 42 Deck Saloon that has been completely outfitted for offshore cruising. This particular vessel, Serendipity, just took first place in its class on the Bahaha, and the owners are moving up to a 50-foot Jeanneau. So let me show you some features and benefits that this vessel has to offer, and look forward to talking with you.
We're gonna start at the bow of the 42 Deck Saloon Serendipity, and as you can see, we have a really nice Celdene bowsprit and a very large Delta-style anchor here. This is a Mark Lombard design hull, and this particular vessel is very fast and also very stable. So if you're looking for a good offshore cruising vessel that has the stability and performance, this is something that I would highly recommend taking a look at. One thing about this vessel that is quite unique is it has the teak decks. So the teak decks are in excellent condition. The vessel has just been recently buffed, waxed. The varnish on the tow rails have been completely done. The oil on the decks have just been done, and it is in prime condition. As you can see, we have a low profile dodger, a bimini that collapses back, and then also on the bimini itself, there are soft solar panels that get situated up on top and allows you to have extra solar on the vessel. But as you can see, I mean, from the decks themselves to the the continuous tow rail that's been revarnished and the hull itself, Serendipity is in prime condition and looks phenomenal. We have spinnaker blocks back here. We also have an outboard lift. There is a dinghy that comes with the vessel. We have a really nice Kato style davit system off the back with integrated solar panels as well. There is an isolated backstay for a single sideband. The vessel is equipped with a huge amount of battery capacity and lots of great options. There's the MOM 8 right here on the back, and also a throwable device. Back here are the cables that go up to the solar panel when the vessel has the bimini out. But let's come aboard the vessel. And you're gonna notice that we have a really nice, there's a swim step shower back here. At the starboard helm, we have our engine instrument controls. There are really low engine hours on the boat. The vessel has about 500 engine hours on it. And this is the Yanmar phenomenal engine. We also have at the starboard helm a Raymarine ST6002 autopilot, tri-data, windpoint wind speed, two-speed Harkin winches. We have our Plastimo compass right here, but a really nice height. One thing I also want to point out to you is, you know, the angle of its design here really gives you some great footing stability when underway. Centrally located is our E80 chart plotter, and we also have a ICOM 424 VHF located right here in the cockpit. Walking over to the port helm, we have our windpoint wind speed, a tri-data, and a Sony stereo remote, two-speed Harkin winches. The general winches are located really aft, so this vessel is very, very easy to single hand or shorthand sail. As we look up forward, we have also instrumentation for graphic repeaters, and then we also have a windpoint wind speed here on this custom pod. So that's a really nice addition, so everybody else in your cockpit can see what you're seeing. There's also electric two-speed Harkin cabin top winch as well. And I'm going to take you out the side, which is very easy because there's a nice integrated step right here on the side deck, allowing you a nice easy passage all the way up forward. Built-in stainless steel handrails, a very large high-end Harkin Traveler system with an upgraded purchase system. And as you can see here, the main sheet itself has a phenomenal purchase to it. And then there's also a boom brake installed. Celdene rigid boom vane and the furling system. These are really high-end sails found on this particular vessel that are in like new condition. As we walk up forward, you can see just how beautiful the teak decks are. It really sets it apart. We have a quick windlass here. This is the Celdene bowsprit. So what happens is it just unclips off of this D-ring that's located right here and clips back down onto it, locking itself into place. And as we walk up forward, you can see that the tack line is situated right to the end of it, so it allows you to fly the asymmetrical spinnaker with ease. Looking back aft, you can see all of the sheets and halyards getting led into the cockpit. This is a double spreader Celdene mast with a large radar reflectors at the top. We have the stainless steel Riley mount surrounding the radar, and then the spinnaker pole that's attached to the front side of the mast. And that also has pulley systems, allowing you to have a full adjustment from that car. So it's a really nice upgraded addition. As we move back aft, you can see just how easy it is to walk along the side decks of the vessel. The canvas is in really good condition. Once again, integrated stainless steel handrails, really nice position steps, allowing you great access in and out of the cockpit. The cockpit itself possesses lots of great stowage. We have a full deep cockpit locker here. There's also a washdown pump in the back. This is a dedicated propane locker. And then off to the starboard and port side is our really large deep lockers, possessing lots of great storage. So as we walk up above, as I mentioned, all the sheets and halyards are led back. They're all properly labeled. We have a Harkin cabin top winch. And then as we make our way down into the vessel, the galley is off to the starboard side. We have a double stainless steel burner stove and oven. A really nice large capacity refrigerator with a small freezer compartment integrated into it. Lots of cabinetry stowage, a very large stainless steel sink. So this is a really nice addition here. So the countertop and just the use of the galley is really, really well thought out. As this opens up, we have our trash can, additional stowage, shelving throughout. Directly across from us is the nav station. The nav station is forward facing and has a nice built-in seat here with integrated stowage. And then we have our SSB. This is a ICOM 802 single sideband VHF. We have our 110 and our 12 volt panel. We also have a second E80 GPS chart plotter with your Xantract inverter charger controls right here. Just forward of that is the stereo system for the vessel. Lots of cabinetry found throughout. We have the Seatalk high-speed network cable, and then we also have the Outback inverter charger. So these are really high-end components found on this vessel. The owner spared no expense in outfitting the vessel to do the Bahaha and a lot of the offshore cruising. But as you can see here, the salon and the large windows just possess lots of natural light, flooding the salon with just a nice, airy, open feel. A flat screen television mounted up on the bulkhead. As we walk up forward to the V-berth, you're gonna see the V-berth itself is quite large. They have it beautifully decored. And we have the second head. This is a Japsco Quiet Flush electric toilet. A large mirror. The holding tank is located behind that. The vanity itself is angled, so when you're standing here, you can actually see yourself in the mirror. And then a really nice molded sink. The V-berth is quite large. We have shelving found throughout. There's an overhead opening hatch, and then there is a really nice large hanging and shelving locker here with additional stowage for shoes and so forth below. As we walk back aft, you can see that the salon itself possesses kind of a two-part. So there's a large bench seat here that you can lounge out in, and then another U-shaped dinette area. We have our ship's air conditioning controls. So the air conditioning system will run off of shore power. Lots of integrated storage found throughout. But as we walk aft, I'm going to show you this is the day head or master cabin head. We have access into the aft cabin from this door, but I'm going to walk through the galley and just give you a little tour from this point. We have hanging lockers and stowage found throughout here. There's lots of great side ports and opening ports from the side and overhead. LED interior lights that the owner has upgraded. And then a phenomenal centerline king berth. So this is pretty unique in a 42-foot vessel. And as you can see, there's an opening port there, and it also has an indentation going up. So it really gives you the sense of a lot of headroom and height. Down here are all of the battery switches from the engine, the winches, the inverter. Really impressive, the electrical and battery system on this vessel. The vessel itself has over 1,000 amp hours of 12 volt capacity. So this is, once again, something very rare and unique in a vessel of this size. And then here facing forward is the aft master's television. So this is a great orientation for that. And then bench seats on both sides with additional stowage on each. I'm gonna walk past this area and show you the access into the master cabin head and shower. So this is a great area here. Really nice molded sinks. Once again, Japsco quiet flush toilets. And then here is the shower area. And this is the grate where all the water drains down into. And then as we move up forward, see what happens here is this handle lifts up and goes into position. And then you have curtains that fully surround you in the shower, keeping the rest of the head dry. Well, I hope you found this short video to be helpful and informative. If you want more information on Serendipity, the 2006 Jeanneau 42 Deck Saloon, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you, telling you all of the features and benefits that this vessel has to offer, and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.